Hi, hello everyone. Let me give a quick intro about myself. This is Vishnu Teja, working as an assistant manager in one of the top construction companies in India. Today we're going to learn about an interesting topic, that is rate analysis. To define rate analysis, it is the rate per unit of a particular item of work. It is mainly used for preparing estimations, budgets, cost reports and cost analysis for the construction projects. Let's see the definition again. Rate analysis. Rate per unit of a particular item of work. This is mainly used for finding the value of work. Let's see a small example here. Value of work is equal to unit rate into quantity of work. I have considered 5000 rupees per cubic meter as the unit rate and 10 cubic meters as the quantity of work. So the value of work is equal to 50,000 rupees. Let's see some important terminology and talk about some parameters used for making the analysis. Productivity, rates and availability of resources, type and scope of work, technical specifications. The first one is the productivity. Productivity is the rate of output per unit of labor or the equipment engaged for the particular work. For example, let us consider an excavator excavates 800 cubic meters of earth in a duration of 8 hours in a day. Then the productivity is equal to work done by duration. So 800 by 8, that equal to 100 cubic meters per hour. This is the productivity. And the second one is the rates and availability of resources. The rates of materials or the resources depends upon the availability and demand for the resources. For example, the cost of aggregate may be less when more quarries are available near the project location. The third one is the type and scope of work. The scope of work plays a crucial role in finalizing the total number of resources required for the project, whereas the type of work decides the type of resources required. The fourth one, technical specifications. Each work has its own specifications. The specifications may be of Indian standard IS, BIS, or maybe of IRC, MoRTH, ASTM, NBC, CPWD. It depends upon the contract also in some specific cases. For example, the minimum cement content of M20 grade concrete is 300 kgs per cubic meter under mild exposure as per IS 456 code. So this is one type of specification providing by Indian standard 456 code. Since we are talking about cost, I just want to tell you about the cost of the project. The cost of the project can be divided into two categories. One is direct cost. The second one is indirect cost. Direct cost is the price that can be directly attributed to the production of the service, like the cost of materials, labor, equipment. All this comes under direct cost. Indirect costs are the costs incurred to facilitate the service, like the overhead costs. That means the security costs, project management costs, all this administration costs, all this comes under the indirect cost. So the profit is equal to sales minus cost. Let's see how we are going to do this. Let me show you the breakdown structure of the rate analysis before we start. There are five components in the rate analysis. I'm defining the cost here. The first one is the material. The material cost consists of the cost of materials used for the work. It may be the cost of cement, aggregate, admixture for concrete works, or maybe the cost of cement, bricks and aggregate for the brickwork, because these are the materials which are going to be used to complete the work. Second one is the plant and machinery. The cost of plant and machinery part consists of the total hire charges of the machinery and plant used to complete the work. like the higher charges of dumpers, concrete mixers, batching plants, generators, all this comes under plant and machinery cost. The third one is the labor. It is the cost of labor charges engaged for the work. Next, fourth one is the profit. Profit is the income earned by the contractor after deduction of all the costs. And fifth one, overheads. Overheads are the indirect costs or the expenses for operating the business, like the cost of furniture or the security, staff salaries, documentation works. All this comes under overhead. The cost of material, machinery, labor put together gives the basic cost of the work. And one more thing we need to define here, that is the direct costs and indirect costs. The cost of material, labor and machinery put together gives the direct costs, and the overheads gives the indirect costs. Now let's do an exercise. I'm going to analyze the unit rate of concrete. The unit of measurement is cubic meters. The cement, aggregates, admixture and water, all this falls under material part. And in the machinery part, if you see the transit mixer for conveying the concrete, the batching plant with the generator for production of concrete, the wheel loader for feeding of aggregates, and concrete pump for pumping the concrete if it is required. Here I am assuming that the concrete is for foundation. Then comes the labor, third part. These are the labor used for production of concrete, placing, laying and vibrating the concrete, and also for curing. Then did we miss anything? Yes, shuttering. This is the most important thing for casting the concrete structures, shuttering. So let's start making the analysis now. I gave a hyperlink here. Let's go to the format. Let's see the format now. This is the format. This is the typical format for rate analysis. So the first column, serial number. Next, the description of item, quantity, unit of measurement, rate per unit and the amount. Amount is equal to quantity into rate per unit. Here in these columns, we are going to calculate the quantities required. I'll show one by one how we have to calculate each and every quantity one by one. I'll show. Coming to the format, there are 5 heads here: materials, plant and machinery, labor, overheads and profit. I'm going to add all the resources under this 5 heads. Before adding the resources, I must list out them to make sure that there is no duplicate and nothing is missed out. And while listing, better to give the unit of measurement. Let's see the mix design. Here you can see the mix design of concrete, which is having the quantity of material required to prepare 1 cubic meter of concrete. This is the unit of measurement. See carefully, these unit of measurements plays very crucial role in making the rate analysis. Cement of 365 kgs is required, 20mm aggregate 700 kgs, 10mm 465 kgs, fine aggregate of 745 kgs. This is the admixture for concrete, 2.5 kgs per cubic meter. Here these quantities include the wastage, which is given here. This is just for my consideration. I just assumed these wastage percentage and have applied here. These quantities are already inclusive of the wastage. So now let's start working out the unit rate. So these are the list of items. As I've told you, we need to list out the items and to make sure that there is no duplicate and nothing is missed. So these are the list of materials, these are the list of machinery, and this is the list of labor. So I'm starting with the material part first. If you see the material part here, there are 7 columns here. You can see here description, unit of measurement, basic cost of material, carriage cost, tax, and total rate. Here total rate is the sum of basic cost plus carriage cost plus tax. This is how we usually calculate the rate of a material. I'm giving this cost based on the data provided by the procurement department. This is the 5000 rupees is the basic cost of the cement, and then comes the carriage cost. Here the cement is being procured from a location which is 100 kilometers away, and they are charging 2.5 rupees per kilometer per metric ton. So the lead is 100 kilometers and the carriage rate is 2.5 rupees per kilometer per metric ton. So I need to calculate the carriage cost, and I should add here. So carriage cost per metric ton is equal to 100 into 2.5. So the cost of carriage per metric ton is equal to 250 rupees. So this I'm going to add here. So we got the basic cost, carriage cost, then tax. Tax is applicable on the basic cost, which we are going to pay to the government, and the total rate of cement 6,650 rupees. Usually the transportation rate may not be constant. The rate, I mean, I'm talking about this 2.5. The transportation rate may not be constant and varies for every 10 to 15 kilometers, 10 to 25 kilometers, something in that range. So just keep in mind this. And then comes the other materials. One thing I want you to tell you is, in case if you want to estimate the rates of works awarded by the state government department, you can use the standard schedule of rates of the respective state governments to get the rates. I'll show you a sample of that. This is the standard schedule of rates. Here you can see the rates of labor, all the labor. Here you can see the rates, labor wages per day. Here you can see the rates of materials in this SOR published by the PWD department. This consists of labor wages, rates of materials per unit, rates of some works analyzed by the PWD department. So now let's go to the Excel. Similarly, I'm calculating the rates of other materials also. And the aggregate is being transported from a quarry location which is 50 kilometers away from the batching plant location. So here I need to add the transportation cost. As I've said, 50 kilometers is the lead, 50, here 50, because all these three are aggregate. So the rate, unit rate is 5 rupees per kilometer per metric ton. So the carriage cost is equal to 250 rupees, same as cement, but here the rate is different. Please do remember this. So the tax is as applicable. Like I have calculated the rate of cement, I'm just calculating the rates of all the aggregates. Then comes the admixture. The cost of admixture is 40 rupees. The carriage cost is 3 rupees per kilo. And the tax part. So the total cost is basic cost plus carriage cost plus tax, which is equal to 50 rupees. Clear? So the rates of materials is frozen now. let's start making the analysis, rate analysis. Here we have the quantities of materials required to prepare 1 cubic meter of mix. Here we are going to cast 2 concrete foundations. You can see the dimensions here, 15 meters by 20 meters by 0.2 in the figures. Let's calculate the quantity of concrete. Quantity of concrete is equal to 15 into 20 into 0.2 into 2. This is the total quantity of concrete. Whenever you make a calculation or you enter a number, make sure that you enter the units. Unit of measurement is very important in this analysis. So we got the quantity of concrete here. Now let's calculate the materials required for making this 120 cubic meters of concrete. We got the rates of materials, we got the quantity of concrete. So let's start the analysis in the material part. So the quantity required to prepare 1 cubic meter of concrete is 365 kgs. So 365, I'm just copying the data here, I'm just linking this. So quantity to be produced is 120 cubic meters. I'm just freezing by pressing F4. So 120 cubic meters, this is in kgs, all are in kgs, this is in cubic meters. So total quantity of here, the total quantity refers to the total quantity of material, not the total quantity of concrete. So the total quantity of material we get by calculating this one with this. So 365 into 120, that is 43,800 kgs of cement. Similarly, I'm just dragging the formula down so that we can calculate all the quantities of materials. This is in kgs, but here the rates are for metric tons. For cement, for coarse aggregate and fine aggregate, the unit of measurement and the rates are for metric tons, except for admixture. So the quantity of the admixture calculated remains same, but here we need to make a conversion by dividing these numbers with 1000 so that the quantities will be converted to metric tons. All these 4, cement, coarse aggregate of 20 mm, 10 mm and fine aggregate. So the quantities are calculated, and let's give the unit of measurement here. So it's clear, I think this is clear. So we got the quantities of materials. I'm just taking these quantities here, 43.8, 84, 55.8, 89.4, 300 kgs. So the unit of measurement should be shown here in the analysis. So rate per unit, this should come from here. Cement, coarse aggregate of 20 mm. There should, please make sure that there should not be any mismatch while making this. Fine aggregate and admixture. So the amount you will get by multiplying the quantity with the rate per unit. So just drag the formula here. So this is how we have to make the analysis for the material part. Now this is clear. Then we go to the machinery part. Here, batching plant is required, which is fitted with the generator of 100 kVA and then a loader of 1 cubic meter capacity, transit mixer and concrete pump. Please carefully notice the unit of measurements are in hours, except for the transit mixers. Transit mixers, the unit of measurement is per cubic meter per kilometer. because the rate which we are going to put here is based on this unit. Okay, now let's start. First of all, I'm going to enter the hire charges of the machineries which I got from resource and plant and machinery department. So the hire charges of batching plant of 30 cubic meter capacity is 2200 per hour, generator 500 per hour, so loader 1 cubic meter capacity 700 per hour, transit mixer it is 30 rupees per cubic meter per kilometer, the concrete pump is being hired at 300 rupees per hour. As I have said, I got all the rates from plant and machinery department or from the resources department. You can get the higher charges of machines from SOR also based on the use of unit rate analysis. So here one important thing we need to analyze here. For making the analysis in the machinery part, we need to freeze a certain quantity which was already done here. Here we have calculated the quantity of concrete. From the total quantity, we can analyze the resource requirements. Based on the site requirement and production capacity of the plant, we can make the analysis actually. So here I am considering batching plant CP30. That means it can produce a theoretical production of 30 cubic meters per hour. Taking the efficiency of the batching plant into consideration at 70%, it can produce 20 cubic meters on average. Let's start making the analysis. I'll just add some rows here. Just copy and paste here as values. So here you need to give the unit of measurement, hour. I'm just dragging this. So the rate per unit which we already have. Remember, these rates are per hour and this is per cubic meter per kilometer. So we are going to calculate this quantity. Okay, as I have said, I am considering batching plant of CP30. That means it can produce a theoretical quantity of 30 cubic meters per hour. So taking the efficiency of the batching plant into consideration at 70%, it can produce 20 cubic meters per hour. So to complete 120 cubic meters of production, how many hours is required for this batching plant? That's what I'm going to calculate. Because why I'm saying batching plant is because all these machineries listed here at the bottom, all these four machineries are dependent upon this batching plant production. So 20 cubic meters is the actual production of the batching plant and 120 cubic meters is the quantity of concrete. So total hours required for the batching plant to produce 120 cubic meters of concrete is 120 by 20, that is 6 hours. Clear? So I'll just take this here, 6 hours. If the batching plant runs for 6 hours, obviously the DG runs for 6 hours and the loader has to run for 6 hours and the concrete pump has to run for 6 hours. Everything is calculated except this transit mixer. Here we need to enter the quantity which is equal to lead from batching plant to the site location. Usually we maintain lead charts to find the lead. Here you can see the typical lead chart. This is the batching plant location and here is one more batching plant location. The red color one is the road alignment of a project and these are the access routes. These are the access routes. So to convey concrete from batching plant location to a structure location which is here. The transit mixer has to travel through all these routes, which is equal to the lead. So I am considering a lead of 15 kilometers here. So now let's calculate the amount. So quantity into rate per unit. Control D, done. Then comes the labor part here. So let me give the rates first. 500 rupees per day, 600 rupees per day, 400 rupees per day. You can take the wages from SOR of the state or even from Delhi schedule of rates, which is being published by the Central Public Works Department, based on the use of the unit rate analysis basically. So let's go to the analysis. Here we need to calculate the quantities. So then let me enter all this. Here we need to calculate the quantities of the labor required to produce this much of concrete, not only for production, for laying, for compacting, for everything. So let's see how we are going to do this. Usually the data for analyzing the labor is generally taken from the practical production data of these previous projects, because this varies from location to location and even from sector to sector. Sector to sector in the sense, like bridges, it will be different for bridges, it will be different for buildings, it will be different for culverts, dams, irrigation projects, like these kind of projects. So for this you can also refer some standard publications like Delhi analysis of rates, which is being published by the Central Public Works Department. This is how it looks like. I'll show you a sample. Delhi analysis of rates. This is the Delhi analysis of rates of 2016, yeah, published by the CPWD. Our standard schedule of rates, which is being published by the state PWD department, I have already shown that. Or even the data from standard data book also you can use, which was published by the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, MoRTH. Here for this analysis I'm going to take the data from the previous projects. So I'm just entering that one here. Mate 1 number, Mason 3 numbers, Mazdoor 18 numbers. All these three are used for concrete production, laying and compaction, also for curing. I believe we got all the data now, right? So let's start calculating. So let's start calculating the basic cost now. Basic cost is the sum of material, machinery and labor. So this is the basic cost. Then comes the shuttering. I'm just saving this. Actually, we need to make the separate analysis for shuttering, because there are different categories available in shuttering, like plywood, timber, steel formwork, etc. And there are very good innovative techniques being followed at site, especially for shuttering. Like I said, it differs from location to location and even from sector to sector. So I'm not going to make analysis for the shuttering. I will take the cost of shuttering based on the previous project data and escalating it to the current year actually. So if you want, you can make your own analysis, or you can take the rates from SOR or from Delhi analysis of rates also. Since it is shuttering, the unit of measurement is usually the square meters. But I'm going to tell you how we have to give the cost of shuttering here. Let me calculate the shuttering quantity of these structures. unit of measurement. So shuttering is the perimeter of the section into the depth. So 15 into 2 plus 20 into 2 into 0.2. This is for one section, and for two sections that is into 2. So it is the shuttering quantity. So from my analysis, rate of shuttering for foundation works is 350 rupees per square meter. So that is for foundation works, only for foundation works. Please remember, this is only for foundation work. This is from the analysis which I have made. The concrete analysis we are making per cubic meter of concrete. But here, the rate of shuttering is in square meter. So we need to make a conversion here. So conversion, how we are going to make the conversion is, I'll tell you. Let's calculate the shuttering factor. Shuttering factor is equal to total shuttering quantity by shuttering factor is equal to total shuttering quantity by total concrete quantity. We have both the quantities, this shuttering quantity and this is concrete quantity. So 0.233 is the shuttering factor. And the unit of measurement is square meters per cubic meter. We know the cost of shuttering per square meter. We know the shuttering factor. So let's calculate the cost of shuttering. So we can calculate in two ways. One is direct shuttering quantity into rate of shuttering. That gives 9,800 rupees. Or you can do in this way also, shuttering factor into quantity of concrete into rate of shuttering, and the both should be same. So we got the cost of shuttering also. We can directly put this value here, or we can consider some percentage of the basic cost of concrete. So based on the site experience and to maintain some cushion in the data analysis, I am considering 4% of the basic cost of concrete as the shuttering cost. There may be variation for this, but in considering so that some cushion also will be maintained in this analysis. So let's see the overhead part. Let's have a look at some indirect expenses in the project. You can see here the staff salaries, security expenses, conveyance expenses, all this. I'm going to explain how to analyze this. So the first part is the staff salaries. You can see the staff listed here, designation wise, and the number of staff here in the project and the duration of the project. Here it is the compensation per month, that means the salary per month. So the total cost which is being paid to this concerned staff throughout the project duration is this. How we need to calculate is number of staff into duration into compensation per month. That gives the total cost which is being paid to the staff. So this is how we get the cost of staff salaries. And then security expenses. Security expenses, there are total 6 number of securities. The duration remains same. So compensation being paid for each and every security person is 20,000 rupees. So total cost is equal to 6 into 12 into 20,000. That is 14,40,000. And then comes the conveyance expenses. Conveyance expenses are the higher charges of the vehicles which are used for moving from one place to another place. Here 6 conveyance vehicles are being used throughout the project duration, and the 60,000 is the higher charges for each vehicle, 43 lakhs. 20,000 is the total cost of conveyance. And then printing and stationery expenses. How most of these values are assumed values only. So this is 30,000 per month. So 12 into 30, that is 360,000. Then comes the safety equipment and lab equipment like this PPEs, safety nets, safety shoes, helmets, all these comes under, and the lab testing equipment, all this comes under this. So the compensation here I have considered is 50,000. So 12 into 50,000, 6 lakhs rupees. There will be some more indirect expenses in the project which are not accounted monthly. Non-recurring expenses like inauguration cost, CRS activities, printers and computers, temporary structure installation like site office, batching plant, labor camp, all this kind of. But all these expenses are for the total project and not only for the analysis we make. So I want to use all these resources for producing only 120 cubic meters of concrete. Correct. But for all other work, so we can estimate the total value of work and distribute the indirect expenses based on certain percentage. So usually this kind of analysis is used for making the project budgeting. So whatever the I've just calculated all this just to show how to calculate the indirect expenses, but here I'm going to consider a certain percentage for overheads, that is 10% of the cost of materials, plant and labor and the shuttering. So that means basic cost plus shuttering cost into 10%. So this is the cost of overheads, total cost of overheads. So let's calculate the cost including overheads. So the cost including overheads is equal to the sum of overheads, shuttering cost and basic cost. So 6,39,104 is the total cost including the overheads. I want you to do a small exercise in this topic, that is finding the mistake in the analysis. I wantedly made a miscalculation while making the analysis and you have got 15 seconds to find the mistake without rewinding the video. I'll turn on the timer for you. Ready? 1, 2, 3. That's it, 15 seconds. Here we have miscalculated one thing, that is cost of transportation of concrete. The cost of transportation is equal to lead into quantity into rate of transportation, like we have calculated for the materials. In the same way we have to calculate for concrete also. But here if you see, while calculating the cost of transportation for concrete, we did not multiply here with the quantity like we did here, we did not do here. So because here it was calculated per unit, but here we are going to make the analysis for 120 cubic meters. So we have to multiply this one with 120. I am multiplying with this one with the quantity to be produced here. So 54,000. So this is the actual cost of transportation of concrete. So everything got revised, even the basic cost, shuttering cost, overheads, cost including overheads, everything got revised. So now we have the actual figures. This is why we must be very very cautious while making the rate analysis. Then comes the last and important thing, that is profit. Like I said, profit is equal to sales minus cost. But if you want to determine the value of sales, we need to assume certain percentage of cost of all the works as a profit. Usually contractor's profit is considered as 10% of the project cost. It may vary from project to project also, and even from sector to sector. So to finalize the analysis, I am considering 10% of the cost of works plus overheads as the profit. So this into 10%, that is 70,038 rupees. So the total cost is equal to cost including overheads plus profit. So let's add these two. This is the total cost. And the final step in the analysis, that is calculating the unit rate. So here we need to enter the quantity, total quantity. So the cost per unit is equal to total cost incurred by total quantity produced, that is 6420 rupees per cubic meter of concrete. You can round this one to the nearest number. One important thing you need to remember here is that the data I have considered for this analysis is not the standard data. It is based on certain considerations and assumptions which will vary from project to project. I just tried to explain the basics of rate analysis. So let's see what we have covered so far in this tutorial. Use of rate analysis, classification of project costs, components of rate analysis of concrete.